In the previous episodes, we actually were able to read the paid source for the Yahoo Finance website, and we were also able to separate the unimportant part from the important bit that contained the historical stock data. Now, in this particular episode, what we'll do is we'll try and actually extract each row of the table from the important bit of the paid source. Let's get on to that task, and we can do that by actually using the strsplit function again. So what we'll do is we'll use that function again, and we'll first define a new variable called temp2, and we'll use strsplit, and we'll have temp1 here as the input, and inside the single quotes we need to write a particular string phrase that actually helps MATLAB locate each row of data in the table. Like we discussed in the second episode, the data is actually located in a row-wise fashion in the table, and we can identify the row by identifying the term date in the paid source. What we'll do is we will actually just copy and paste the term from curly braces to the closing of the double quotes, and inside that is date. We'll copy that term and we'll paste it inside single quotes. What this will do is it will enable MATLAB to actually check this portion of the web page, the portion after historical price store, and it will allow MATLAB to actually, I think, to have selected more than I needed to. Okay, we're back here. So this particular statement will allow MATLAB to actually look for the string date, this particular string, and then it will split the data after it has found date. So it will split the data after each date value or string it encounters. So let me just run this code and check if I get any results. I expect for you all to understand how the function strsplit works by looking at its result. So I'll also use curly braces inside temp1 and a colon inside that to actually access the element inside the cell temp1. Because if you do not use that particular syntax to access the element in temp1, we will get a very big error stating that the function strsplit cannot access the element in temp1. So let's just run these few lines of code again, and we will find in temp2 we have a cell value, and this cell actually contains the historical data for each row of the table. Now you will see that the first element is actually nothing but a simple opening rectangular brace. So the first element is something that we can delete, and you will also find that the last element is also something that we can delete or remove from the cell array. So you will check that and find that last element is also something that we can reject, because here, after date, we do not have any values for open, high, low, close, and volume, and other prices. So we can actually remove the last element entirely, irrespective of what date or what company we've chosen. Similarly, we can remove the first element as well, because this element will always be an opening rectangular brace, no matter which company or period or frequency we choose. And apart from the first and the very last element in the cell array, you will see that every other element contains the data we've been looking for, which is we have a very long number, that is the date, followed by the opening price, the high price, the low price, sorry, the closing price, the volume, and the adjusted closing price. So you can check this for all remaining cells and you will find that we have the data there. So in this episode, we were able to actually split the data more, and we were able to actually get the data that we wanted for each row of the table and save it in a variable called temp2. However, we can actually refine the result that is stored in temp2 by actually redefining temp2 again and saving in it the values starting from the second element to the second last element, because the first element and the last element contains no data or value. What we'll do is we'll just run this last line over here, and we find that this has changed the value in the temp variable. Over here, you will find that in temp2 variable, I no longer have the first empty row, the first empty element, and I also do not have the last element that had a very long char array. Let's open this one. So now I only have in temp2 the data that actually is relevant for further computation. So I'll stop the discussion of how we can actually extract data from the paid source over here, and we can continue our discussion in the next episode, wherein we'll analyze how we can actually get some particular data from each cell element of temp2 variable. So in the next episode, we will learn how we can actually extract these numerals after each string. Like, we'll learn how to extract the opening price, the high price, the date, and every other feature from each cell of the temp2 variable. Till then, I'd again ask you all to understand how the function strsplit works by experimenting with it. And if you guys have any queries, any kind of questions about anything that was covered so far, remember to post it in the comment section below. Till then, it's bye bye from me.